Thank you so much, everybody. It's a wonderful, wonderful opportunity to play in this beautiful hall, come back to Toronto after many years. I've been looking forward to this for a long time. Thank you very much. Let me first introduce you before I start. I'm very, very proud to have with me a member of, he was a member of my very first group back in 1978. Sponsors him from Paris, France, to come over, and he's played with everybody under the sun since then. And now we're back together playing. It's from Paris, France. It's Philippe Sace. From Jersey City, this is the place where I was born and he was raised. This is Luis Alicea on drums. Luis Alicea. From the Vatican, no, I'm kidding. This is his first gig with us tonight. He's an amazing musician. He had played with a band of mine, I don't know, probably about, I don't know how many years ago, 6 years ago or something. And he's now a Berkeley music professor. His name is Mike Pope. Mike Pope. That's about it. So anyway, our relationship, musically speaking, goes back at least 35, maybe more years. And this wonderful man, who's like my brother, has played in at least, I don't know, 20 different formations of groups, and at least 40 of my albums. I don't know how many I have, but he's been on a lot of them. And we just had the greatest time ever. This is Gumby Ortiz on percussion. And I'd like to introduce my guitar. This is the one that I used the day I got the gig with Chick Corea. And I used it on my first four albums. And believe it or not, I haven't played it since 1978. So we're back.
Thank you.
takes me all the way back. And it's like 45 years ago. Going back to this music, and it's a blast. And I know a lot of you are following through the decades. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you very much. This next piece was the first piece that I rehearsed when I was 19 years old with Chicoria, and right out of Berklee School of Music. I had the wonderful opportunity, it was like a dream come true really, to play with my favorite group, Return to Forever. And it was an amazing little story that I like to tell. Because while we were at school, my buddies and myself, we'd see the band play whenever they came to Boston. And on the third visit, they came, and Earl Clue, wonderful acoustic player, wonderful. Oh, I love Earl. They actually put a Les Paul in his hands, and he ran it through a Marshall. And I said to myself, well, wow, that's very interesting. I never thought Earl would play electric guitar. And I just made a mention to a buddy of mine back in New Jersey, and I said to him, man, that's really, he might be like just sitting in for somebody. Maybe they're looking for another guitar player. But I'd love to play with that band. So, but this friend of mine was really like my older brother. He was like right out of Woodstock, you know, always high. And he was a very, very amateurish recording engineer. And he had recorded me on a New Year's Eve when I was 17 years old, playing with the Barry Miles Quartet. And he said to me, it's New Year's Eve. Take this little tab and just enjoy yourself. I said, what is that? I was very naive to all of that kind of stuff. Let me tell you something. It was the most beautiful experience ever. And I heard the tape a week later and could not believe that it was me. It was better than I ever played, even up to this point. So he took it upon himself. I never asked him to do it, but he took it upon himself to go to New York, find Chick, find the management, and just bug the hell out of them until I would listen to this tape. And they did, just to get rid of him. But they love what they heard, so Chick calls me up and he asked me to join the band. And I was like, you know, off that whole thing. I was just like, just completely surreal moment in my life. So I said, what do I have to do? He says, well, you gotta get to New York, and we gotta rehearse for 2 or 3 days. And then we'll play at Carnegie Hall, which is sold out. So I go home to my parents' house, and my mother says, what are you doing out from school? I said, Mom, I'm playing with Chick. She goes, who's Chuck Korea? I said, no, it's Chuck Korea. Return to Forever, Stanley Clark, Lenny Wayne. It's like a dream come true. My father's at the table. He goes, what the hell are you? Wait, what are you doing? I'm from school. I said, Dad, I'm playing Carnegie Hall on Tuesday night. He's get the hell out of here. You're not playing Carnegie Hall. So this went on for about an hour or maybe three. And I went into the city 2 or 3 days. I rehearsed, and they sent the car out to New Jersey to pick me up, to take me to Carnegie Hall. First show.
Oh, no.
My mother gave me a handful of Xanax. I was fine. And my parents came, and my father's in the back seat looking at me going, are you sure we're going to Carnegie Hall? This is a hoax. I said, Dad, this is really happening. He goes, okay. Well, you know, he said to me, I did tell you how you get the Carnegie Hall. It's practice, practice, practice. But I'm thinking to myself, it's acid, acid, acid. That's how it happened.
True story.
Anyway, so this was the first, what we're gonna do now is the first piece of Chick that I remember rehearsing, and also the first one we recorded when we went into the studio for the first Return to Forever album I was involved with, which was called Where Have I Known You Before? And this is called Beyond the Seven Galaxies.
Yeah.
나무의 밀려 노래 나무의 Francesco Pellegrino, yeah. Yes, Francesco. That was very spontaneous, but we both have an affinity and tremendous love and respect for the late, great Pino Daniele. I had the good fortune of working with him, and he had the most unique voice. This was piece we just played with, the most famous piece of his, called Napoli. And in Italy, people just cry when they hear this piece. And now I'm gonna do something for my record. I hope you don't cry. But if you do, it's a compliment, I hope. Enjoy it. Thank you. That's what it's going to take. You know, I'll send out a friend of mine and see if he can find some. It was in Greenwich Village. I mean, you know, every 2 feet there was a drug dealer. So we got him some pot, and he loosened up. And the very first take after that was the one that wound up on the record. And it was like a magic. It was one of those magic moments that, you know, there's very few of them that you remember that stand out. And that was one of them. You could hear him because we were left. He was left channel. I think I was right channel. So you could really hear the interplay and the conversation. And then at the very end, you hear Paco go, whoosh, and everybody in the control room high fiving. And it was just a moment I never forgot. So we had it. You know, after that record came out, it became a hit single in Germany and France and Italy and Spain. Actually, on the radio constantly. Along with pop, the top pop music, and a very odd thing to have happen. And we had it in our back of the minds to eventually do something together. And it wasn't until 1980 we were approached by an impresario from London, who was actually Paul McCartney's guy now. He started out with us, and he put together the trio with John McLaughlin, myself, and Paco, and that was the beginning of that era. And that's it. I mean, it was an amazing thing to be on stage, and we were really there to impress one another, and the audience got the benefit of seeing some of that. But we were, you know, it's, you know, we had to jump outside of whatever comfort zone we were in and just grow at the moment, you know, and we came up with some pretty cool stuff. And then it was 2020 or 2021, I discovered I had the tapes of the Saturday night, because we did two nights in San Francisco, and I went through the tapes and found all these alternate other pieces that never wound up on Friday night and put out a Saturday night in San Francisco. So that's what's happening now, because it's out. And next month comes out a new double album, a studio album of mine. But we're going to continue with the electric stuff now. How's that? We're going to go into a piece that is the lead-off piece from the record, Casino, my third solo album. Here we go.